A very good morning to you all. This is Rajalakshmi, Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, Adikavinannaya University, Rajamahendravaram. Today, I would like to give a presentation on structural and optical studies on Ce3 plus ion doped L-histidine hydrochloride monohydrate single crystals. What is a crystal? A crystal is matter with structure. The word crystal comes from the ancient Greek word krustalos, which means both rock crystal and ice. The scientific study of crystals is called crystallography. Examples: table salt or sodium chloride, sugar or sucrose, snowflakes, quartz, diamond, etc. The objective of the present study: to grow efficient nonlinear optical semi-organic single crystals based on amino acids to obtain luminescent properties by using low temperature techniques. Importance of nonlinear optical crystals. The organic nonlinear optical crystal plays an important role in second harmonic generation, frequency mixing, electro-optic modulation, and optical parametric oscillation. What is second harmonic generation? It is also called frequency doubling, which is a nonlinear optical process. Here, if you consider two photons with the same frequency, what will happen when they interact with a nonlinear material? They combine, it generates a new photon with twice the energy of the initial photons. That means we can observe the new generated photon with twice the frequency and half of the wavelength. So that conjures the coherence of the excitation. Nonlinear optics produces many excitic events. Here we can observe the crystal when sending the infrared light into this, it displays the green light. Crystal growth. Here we have bulk single crystals and nanocrystals. Bulk single crystals are used for the nonlinear optical applications, for detectors, for semiconductors. The crystals which are used for the nonlinear optical applications can be grown by Jorasky technique, slow evaporation solution technique, Shankar Narayanan Ramasamy technique. For detectors, the crystals can be grown by Jorasky technique, slow evaporation solution technique. For semiconductors, the crystals grown by vertical Bridgman technique. Now we will see nanocrystals. These are also used for semiconductors, and these crystals can be grown by melt growth. After attaining the crystals, we have to go for the characterization. So crystalline perfection can be obtained by using double crystal X-ray diffractometry DCD, multi-crystal X-ray diffractometry MCD, and crystalline structure can be obtained by using PXRD. That means powder X-ray diffractometry. Purity or composition can be obtained by using X-ray fluorescence spectroscopy XRF. Trivalent rare earth metal ions. They exhibit stable emission due to the FF electron transition, eminent for their photoluminescent properties in the visible and near infrared regions. And these are suitable for several applications such as probes, labels, chemo, sensors, etc. This is the structure of L-histidine hydrochloride monohydrate with molecular weight 209.63, belongs to basic amino acid family and is chemically basic in nature, which exhibits high second harmonic generation conversion efficiency. Investigations in the present study. Here I have considered host material as L-histidine hydrochloride monohydrate and rare earth ion Ce3+. Synthesis of the material. Here the saturation solution of 0.02 mole percent of Ce2O3 was dissolved in hydrochloric acid, and later excess of hydrochloric acid is evaporated 3 times using double distilled water. The required amount of 0.98%, that means LHHC, is added to the solution and stirred continuously for 24 hours. This is the solubility curve of pure and Ce3+ ion doped single crystals. Here, as the temperature increases, solubility also increases for both the crystals. But when compared with a pure crystal, Ce3+ ion doped LHHC, it increases with the increase in temperature. Cerium, the rare earth metal ion which is doped in the L-histidine hydrochloride monohydrate. Already we have seen the saturation curve, saturation solution. Now the obtained saturation solution was filtered by using Wattmann filter paper and transferred into a growth vessel and covered with a perforated lid to encourage the slow solvent evaporation. Now after attaining the crystal, we have to check the different planes, and out of those planes I have chosen here 100 plane, which was selected in the present study to impose the orientation in the growing crystal for the uniaxial growth. Single crystals grown by slow evaporation solution technique. These are the crystals which were grown by using slow evaporation solution technique. This is pure LHSC with dimensions 8 by 5 by 3 cubic millimeters, and this is cerium 3 plus ion doped L-histidine hydrochloride monohydrate single crystal with dimensions 30 by 13 by 3 cubic millimeters. Unidirectional or Shankar Narayanan Ramaswamy method of crystal growth. Here we have different steps to attain the crystal in a uniaxial growth. Experimental setup of Shankar Narayanan Ramaswamy method. Here, let us consider a water bath. Place an ampoule inside it. Take a seed crystal of 2 mm and place it at the bottom of the ampoule. Place two ammeters and fix the temperature 42 degrees centigrade at the top of the ampoule and 34 degrees centigrade at the bottom of the ampoule. Feed the saturation solution. Avoid microbial growth. Avoid temperature fluctuations. We can obtain 100% solute can be converted into crystal. So here we can see good quality crystal of growth rate 1 mm per day and which is easy to scale up. This is the real-time photograph of unidirectional growth apparatus in lab. Day-wise analysis of Ce3 plus ion doped LHHC single crystals. This is day 5, day 10, day 15, day 20th. This is the unidirectional single crystal which is grown by Shankar Narayanan Ramaswamy method with 56 mm length, 15 mm diameter, growth rate of 2 mm per day. After attaining the single crystals, we have to go for the experimental techniques. So here we have single crystal XRD, high resolution XRD analysis, Fourier transform, infrared spectroscopy, UVB spectroscopy, TCDTA, energy dispersive X-ray analysis, dielectric studies, Vickers hardness, second harmonic generation, photoluminescence studies, photoconductivity. These are the characterization instruments. Single crystal X-ray diffraction analysis. So here it is clearly observed that pure crystal and cerium 3 plus ion doped LHHC single crystals. So both are in the orthorhombic crystal system with space group P212121 and ABC values. Here we have a slight shift and volume. Here it is decreased in the case of Ce3 plus ion LHHC and alpha equals to beta equals to gamma, which is 90 degrees. Why the crystal rate is reduced after the incorporation of Ce ions in the host crystal, which reduces the crystal lattice due to the existence of the interstitial spaces and also development of local compressive strain in the lattice. High resolution X-ray diffraction analysis. So here this is the pure crystal which is grown in slow evaporation solution technique. Here we can observe a single peak with 13 arc seconds. That means the crystal is free from structural grain boundaries. HRXRD for the Ce3 plus ion doped L-histidine hydrochloride monohydrate single crystals. So here we can observe a single sharp peak. So here the crystallinity is very good when compared with the pure crystal because the full width at half maximum it is 7 arc seconds. Fourier transform infrared spectrum studies. Here for the pure and doped crystals, we have carried out the range between 4000 to 400 cm inverse. Here we can study the influence of Ce3 plus ion on the characteristic vibration frequencies of the functional groups. In the case of pure crystal, broad absorption peak, it is observed from 2500 to 3500 centimeters inverse region. This broad peak is due to the OH stretching of COOH group. But this broad peak is not observed in Ce3 plus ion crystal, that is from 2028 to 3400 centimeters inverse. This shows disappearance of COOH group. The NH stretch peak buried under the OH broad peak of COOH, the broad peak is due to the hydrogen bonding. This indicates that the rare earth metal ions Ce3 plus binds to COO minus in the amino acid. Thus, FTIR indicates that Ce3 plus is coordinated to the carboxylate group present in the LHHC crystal. Generally, the peaks with the frequencies in the range of 300 to 600 centimeters inverse belongs to the rare earth oxygen bonds. The absorption peak at 450 centimeters inverse is the characteristic vibration of CeO2 stretching. From IR spectra of Ce3 plus LHHC, it is observed a strong peak at 451 centimeters inverse, which indicates CeO bond. Functional groups OH, NH was influenced due to the addition of Ce3 plus ion in the LHHC. This is the tabular form for functional groups of the pure and doped LHHC single crystals. So here these are the wave number represented for the pure LHHC, and these are Ce3 plus doped LHHC FTIR wave number in CM inverse, and these are the vibrational band assignments. And for a particular number, here we can observe different stretchings, bonds, etc. Transmittance spectra. Here the optical study of the grown crystals was measured in the wavelength range between 190 and 800 nanometers. The lower UV cutoff wavelength of the pure crystal, it is 260 nanometers, and the transmittance, it is 88%, which is in the accordance with the literature. So here, due to the incorporation of Ce3 plus ion in the LHHC crystal, the UV cutoff wavelength, it is 240 nanometers. The transmittance of doped, SEST and SR grown crystals are 95% and 98% respectively. So here it is observed that Ce3 plus LHHC crystal grown by the SR method has a enhanced transparency. Determination of the optical band gaps. Here by seeing this picture, we can easily observe that the optical band gaps of Ce3 plus LHHC crystals grown by the SEST and SR methods are found to be 4.40 eV, 4.50 eV respectively. So here the band gap energy of the pure crystal, it is 3.90 eV, and which is in the accordance with the literature. And as an outcome of the wide band gap, the crystal possesses excellent transmittance in the visible region. The study of thermogravimetric differential thermal analysis. So from the picture, it is clearly observed that the grown crystals and the TG thermogram finds that there is no loss of weight up to 150 degrees centigrade and 159 degrees centigrade for the pure and Ce3 plus ion crystals respectively with the temperature, and the weight loss at three different temperatures were observed by using differential thermal analysis. So from the recorded data, it is noticed that the endothermic peaks at 151 degrees centigrade and 156 degrees centigrade, which are correspond to the decomposition of pure LHHC and doped LHHC crystals respectively. So it is found that the complete decomposition occurs at a temperature above 650 degrees centigrade and 675 degrees centigrade of the undoped and doped crystals. Hence, the Ce3 plus ion doped LHHC crystal can be retained up to 156 degrees centigrade with good thermal stability and is suitable for the applications. Surface morphology of the Ce3 plus ion doped single crystal. So here it is observed that the image at 60x magnification along 100 plane formation, the crystals of different sizes and the uniformity is found to be disturbed here in this picture. Further, magnified image at 4090x, it is observed that the disclosed rosetty like shape, that is leaflets in tight circular rings aggregated with each other. So by using this EDEX spectrum, we can find out the chemical composition analysis of the grown crystal. So here the percentage of cerium is clear in the EDAX spectra as it is there. So in EDAX spectra, the presence of CnOCl intense peaks are present, which indicates the formation of Ca3+ ion, which is settled in the LHSC single crystal. So in the comparison with the pure crystal, it is observed that the EDAX, which specifies the incorporation of Ca3+ ion in the crystal lattice of LHSC. Micro hardness studies. Here a graph is depicted between the hardness value and the load for the doped and undoped single crystals. In pure and the doped crystals, that means which are grown in the SEST method, it is observed that hardness increases with the increase in load up to P equals to 45 and 56 grams respectively. But in the case of SR grown crystal, it is up to 61 grams, and here we do not observe any cracks. So the enhanced hardness and the mechanical strength of the crystal was due to the incorporation of Ca3+ ion in the host lattice, which is grown by the SR method. Dielectric studies. So here, by seeing this graph, it is easily understand that as the frequency increases, dielectric constant decreases, as in the case of SEST method and also in the case of SR method. Frequency versus dielectric loss. So here a graph is depicted between log F and dielectric loss, and here we have chosen the different temperatures: 35 degrees centigrade, 60 degrees centigrade, 90 degrees centigrade and 120 degrees centigrade. So here by seeing this graph, it is clearly observed that the decrease in the dielectric loss is observed at the higher frequencies. So these materials have enhanced optical quality with minimum defects. Photoluminescence studies. Emission spectrum of the Ca3+ ion doped LHSC. Here we have chosen 0.02 mole percentage of the Ca3+ ion into the LHSC, because we have studied for the 0.01 mole percentage, but we did not obtain any photoluminescence property, so that we have chosen here 0.02 mole percentage of the cerium into the host material. So here this picture represents the emission spectrum of the Ca3+ ion doped LHSC single crystal after exciting at 250 nanometer light, and monitor the corresponding excitation spectrum at 350 nanometers emission. The emission spectrum shows broad band located at the 350 nanometer, attributed to the 5D to 4F transition of Ce3+ ion. The excitation spectrum shows a band at 258 nanometers, attributed to the 4F to 5D transition of Ce3+ ion. This is the decay curve, which is by exponential in nature. The lifetime values corresponding to the 2D3/2 Ce3+ ions, along with the x square value obtained from fitting. Here we have tau 1, tau 2 values. Tau 2, it is 8.8270, which has a long lifetime. Energy levels of Ce3+ with main transitions. So here at 258 nanometer, we have 2F5/2 to 2D5/2, and at 350 nanometer, we have 2D3/2 to 2F5/2 transition, and one more we have 2D3/2 to 2F7/2 transition. Photoconductivity studies. So here in these two graphs, we can observe that dark current is slightly lower than that of photocurrent. So here the SEST grown and SR grown crystals, they are positive photoconductive in nature. Second harmonic generation or nonlinear optical property. And for the pure crystal, it is 3.0 times that of KDP, and for SEST grown CE doped LHCDN crystal, it is 3.4, and SR method Ce3+ ion doped LHSC, it is 3.7 times that of KDP. That means the dopant enhances the optical property. Conclusion. The single crystal XRD analysis of doped samples confirms some minute structural vibrations. FTIR study shows the incorporation of Ce ions through COO group in the LHSC crystal lattice. Optical transmission study shows that the crystal has high transmittance in the visible region. High resolution XRD of the grown single crystal shows reasonable crystal perfection and the absence of grain boundaries. The low value of the dielectric loss at high frequency of the conventional and unidirectional metal doped crystals proves that these materials possess enhanced optical quality with lesser defects, which is an important parameter for nonlinear optical materials. Thermal stability of unidirectional metal doped LHSC crystal is slightly increased while compared with the conventional LHSC crystals. The NLO character of the materials was observed by measuring SHE efficiency by Kutch technique. Decay curve corresponding to the rare earth ions in the LHSC grown crystal is by exponential in nature with a long lifetime. The presence of cerium in the crystal lattice is confirmed using energy dispersive X-ray analysis. The grown crystal has higher hardness value and the crystal belongs to the soft material. The grown crystals belong to positive conductive nature confirmed by the photoconductive plot. It can be concluded that the influence of rare earth metal ion improved SHE efficiency and hence doped crystals are promising materials for radiation detector applications. The present work was published in the Journal of Molecular Structure, Elsevier Publications. Acknowledgements. I wish to express my sincere gratitude to Professor K. Samatha, Professor in Physics, Andhra University, Visakhapatnam, for her supervision. I would like to record my sincere gratitude to Dr. K. Ramchandra Rao, Department of Physics, Government College, Autonomous, Rajamahendravaram, for his co-supervision, advice, and guidance. I extend my gratitude to Dr. K. Ramneshwari, Principal, University College of Science and Technology, Adikavi Nannayya University, Professor Mokka Jagannadharao, Vice Chancellor, Adikavi Nannayya University, Rajamahendravaram, for their valuable support. Thank you.